rest of the stripes on the main part of the zebra's body there. But now I want to show you how to do the fluffy sections of the ear. So we want to mix up a bit more of the black. What you had before, and if you look at your reference image, it's these very dark areas that I'm going to paint next. What I've done is when I traced the image through, I drew around the very dark patches, so I've been left with small, oddly shaped areas to fill in. So they're quite small. We don't need to wet the paper first. I can just go ahead and fill those areas in. So I'm going to start at the top and try and follow the lines that I drew. And looking at my reference image a little bit as well, because these shapes are very strange shapes, so I just want to make sure I'm in the right place. So that's the first one at the top, and there's another one further down. Just fill in those shapes. If you have a fair amount of paint on your brush, you shouldn't need to reload your brush with more paint. And we can do some little lines at the edges to create the hairs. If you just use the tip of your brush and create some finer flicks on some of those edges to create, make it look a little bit more fluffy. Pull some of that dark paint out from the shape outwards and make that look a little bit more fuzzy. To do that, you want to use, if I have a shape like this, let's just put some paint down for you. If I have a shape like this and I've got a lot of paint in the middle, I've got a little puddle, I'm going to use the very tip of my brush and I'm just going to pull some paint, drag some paint out to create little spikes that look like hairs. So in effect, the white of the paper looks like the hairs coming into the black area of his ear. So there's also a couple of little areas underneath, so I'm going to carry on the same technique. So I'm going to firstly fill in the shape that I've drawn, which is like that, and then this other shape here as well. Make sure I've got plenty of paint on my brush. You don't want to flood the paper with paint, but you want to have enough paint on there that it creates a little puddle so that you can pull that paint out to create the little hairs. So I'm going to go ahead and do a little bit more. And then you'll also do exactly the same on the left ear as well. So as you can see, I have painted his left ear as well with the black and the central section, which is still drying at the moment. But I wanted to show you how to paint the outer edge of his ears, because if you look at the reference image, there are dark lines which go all the way on the left ear there. On the right ear it starts part way up and then carries on up to the edge of the painting. So when I was tracing the brush through to the paper, I just press down where I saw those dark marks. So again, we need to mix up some black paint, same consistency as we've just used up in the ear there, so a little bit darker and thicker than we used down in his stripes. So that means you just need a little bit more of the paint in the water to get that deeper kind of black colour. Then I'm going to take a little bit off my brush and I'm first of all going to paint this shape in. So it's fatter at the top and then it comes thinner as it gets towards the bottom. So the way to do that is the fatter section you can press down on the brush a little bit, and then the thinner section you just lift your brush gradually off the paper and it creates a thinner line as you're lifting it away. So press down for a thicker line, and then the more you pull up, the thinner your mark will be, because it'll just be the very tip that touches the surface of the paper. So if you give that a practice on some spare paper first and then go ahead and do it on your painting, that might be a good idea. And then we've also got this solid line going from right from the top of his ear on the left all the way to where his ear meets the side of his head. So I'm just going to go ahead and paint that now. Just got to be careful about this wet paint here, I don't want to touch that. In fact, a good tip for you guys is move your painting, turn your painting to make it easier for you to paint. So it's closer to me if I turn my painting upside down, and I'll start at the bottom of the ear and work my way up. If I draw a line dragging it towards me, I can see what I'm doing rather than starting here and pushing away. It's not as easy for your hand to create that mark. So dragging the paintbrush towards you is always easier to do. So I'm going to start at the bottom, just with the tips of my brush, touching the paper, and then I'm moving my whole arm, dragging that towards me to create quite a fine line. And then I'm just going to, with my paper towel, just touch the edge there on the tape, just to remove that paint. And as you can see, if I turn it round, I now have a good shape around the ears. So just to show you what I've done, when I carried on painting the stripes on his body, I carried on with the pinks down this side, purples, dark purples under his chin, moved into Prussian blue around the edge of his nose here, and as I came up to the back of his body, I started to introduce the hooker's green with the grey as well. So I've kind of got a transition of colour working across my painting. And I've decided when it comes to painting the head, I'm going to continue using the crimson and the ultramarine blue, so a mixture of purples and pinks. But first of all, I've still got my thick grey mix, and I'm going to paint in this shape beneath his eye, and because it's a small shape, I don't need to add water first. I'm just painting it on the dry paper, and I've used quite a thick paint, so it'll be nice and dark, just like I've used on the top of his head and his ears there. So I think we'll also paint his eye as well. So I'm just going to shift around a little bit so that I can paint this a bit easier. So still with that dark paint, and the eye, if I bring in the reference image, there's a patch underneath the eye, and then there's the eye itself with the highlight in the centre. So I want to leave the highlight white. I want to paint around that shape. So the highlight is in the centre here. So first of all, I've painted around that highlight, and now I'm painting up to the edge of the eye shape that I've drawn there. Again, I'm just painting you don't need to wet this because it's quite a small shape. As long as you've got plenty of paint on your brush, then you should be fine. Just take care when it comes to the edges. If necessary, have a look at your reference image and just double check that you've got that right. And you want the eye to be really dark, so I'm just dabbing on more paint to get it as black as I can. And we'll allow that to dry as well. So I can't paint anywhere around the eye now, I need to let that dry. I'm going to paint the next stripe beneath it, which is an unusual shape and it's quite large, so I'm going to go in with my clean brush with clean water and I'm going to just wet that area first of all with the water. Use the very tip of your brush when it comes to the thinner sections. You want to be really careful. It gets quite complicated on his nose, the stripes do, so we're going to definitely need to be careful there to paint the correct bit and to also just be using the tip of our fine brush to get those thinner lines painted in. So I've painted the water on, and as you all know by now, take my thinner brush with the grey and start applying that paint. Just allow it to merge with the water and spread around that shape. Just going to be careful down this section because it's very narrow. That's why we've pre-wet the paper, so that we can take our time painting it in. Just going up to the edges with my brush. Just to get an even grey colour. So it's starting to dry down here already. So I need to quickly wash my brush, some paper towel, take off the excess, and I'm going to come in with some purple, which I have mixed on my palette here. Dried in the palette while I was working on all the grey, so I'm just quickly mixing it up again. I'm going to add in a bit more of the crimson. And I'm going to quickly, because this is dry and I need to work fast, quickly just add in some of that blue as well, the ultramarine blue, to create this nice purple colour. And I'm going to come in dabbing it on. dabbing technique in the puddle of paint that I've created, and it allows that purple to just blend into the grey colour. Just going to dreadle down the outside, I think, of this section. Just make sure I haven't missed any little bits on the edges. Just a bit of tidying up before I finish that.
That looks pretty good.
Okay, so I've carried on a little bit further from where I left off last time. I've carried on and I've painted part of the face in. While painting, I've noticed that, as I said before, these aren't the paints that I usually use, but I'm using them because I know that's the paint that you have to hand. So I wanted to create something that you can create at home. But whilst painting, I've noticed that while I'm painting over here and my hand is rubbing on the surface of the paper here, it's actually moving the paint about and making the white of the paper mucky. So what you might want to do is just a piece of paper folded up, laid down, just so that you can rest your hand on something while you're working, and that way it'll stop it from smudging underneath. The other thing I wanted to show you now is I'm working on this area of the head, and I'd like this to be much more vibrant than the colours within the body and the neck. So I'm using a slightly different technique now. Instead of painting the whole section of the stripe grey, first of all I'm going in with the colour, and then I'm coming in with the grey and gradually blending it in a little bit, so it's slightly different. But this next shape, I actually wanted just to focus on the colour itself rather than any grey at all. So I'm just going to mix up some of the crimson in my palette there, and that is what I'm going to use to paint this next shape that I'm working on, which is this one here with the curl just above the eye. I'm going to take it up so far, and then later on I'll address this area here, which is where all the colours are meeting at the top. So just for the time being, I'm working with my thin brush. I'm going to lay down a piece of paper across the rest of my painting so I don't disturb it. And I just want to make sure I haven't got too much paint on my brush. I'll take a bit of excess off, and I come into that shape and just fill it in with the pink, just as you would do with the grey, but this time just using the crimson instead. So this is going to allow this shape to be really vibrant. It won't be dulled by the grey paint at all. So I thought it'd be really nice to have a focus area on the painting by the eyes of the zebra, and making it really nice and bright. So now I've got that paint down, you can see that it's quite pale and a little bit dull. So what I do is I go straight into my crimson paint here, just with the tip of my brush. I've added some paint, I'm going to just dot it on at the top into that wet pink, and you can see there that it's a lot more vibrant. And I'm just going to let that come down the shape gradually towards the eye. So the colour now is darker or more vibrant at the top, and it fades out as it comes down towards the eye. So that's much brighter than it would have been if I'd added any of the grey in at all. So we're getting a nice focus area at the top there. And we have several stripes next to that one on the side of the head that do the same thing. But what I want to do is bring in some of the grey at the top of the shape. So the next shape along, I'm going to paint slightly differently. I'm going to turn my board around. So effectively I'm starting here by the eye, which is now the top of my shape. I'm going to work my way down towards this part of the head. So I've just got the crimson on my brush and I'm dragging it down towards me, and as I get to the top where it meets the black, I just finish the pink there and make sure the whole thing's covered. And what I'm going to do now is, like I did before, just pop a bit of the crimson on the end of the shape, nice and bright there. I'm going to clean off my brush and then I'm going to pick up a little bit of the grey and add some of that grey to this bottom section of the shape, so the one towards the top of his head, if you like. So that's got some grey on it now that's going to blend down. And I'm going to do exactly the same for the next couple of stripes as well. I'm just going to check with my reference image that I'm working on the correct shapes. So the next one along is quite a fat shape. Yeah, that's right. So the next one along is this one. So I'm going to do the same again. Wash my brush. Go into my crimson. First of all, paint it. Allow it to fill that shape. Up to where I painted the head grey there. Wipe off my brush. Just pick up some stronger crimson straight from the palette. That's quite a strong text in the back, so that's a little bit stronger now at the end there. And now I'm going to add some of that grey paint to this section, like I did to the shape before. Okay, so that's now got that lovely grey at the top again. So that just needs to dry. That's better. Made a bit of a mistake in the previous one, so I've just fixed that. And I'm going to do the same with the next couple of stripes as well.